r/askreddit/reddit and chill. What's one sex thing you did when you were crazy horny but when it was done you were just like, what have I done? Tried a vacuum out when I was about 14 and it hurt quite a bit. So I tried it again a few months later and it still hurt. Probably shouldn't have turned it on. Tried the old heating up a banana peel, DIY pocket pal, when I was somewhere around 13. I mean it felt great. But afterward I looked at the carnage and thought, this isn't your best moment. Now that's just awful. I've never heard of jacking it with a banana peel. But in the interest of safety, you should let everyone know exactly how long to microwave the peel. For various wattages. So none of the disgusting perverts around here burn their penises. Why do you think it was kept around so long? Too many to count. Weirdest was probably when I was 15. Thought it'd be cool to plant my seed, so I stuck my dong in a pot of dirt, about 2 inches down, and kept it planted until I finished the deed. I sat there in my own mess and thought, what the duck is wrong with me? A question that goes unanswered. And? Did they grow a plant? Jacked off with some random bottle of lotion my wife had. It was self-tanning cream. Turned my dong in one palm orange for a week. Donald Pump. Edit. Thanks for the golden karma. Me and my cousin dry hump wrestled each other when we were 12 all the way to the end. People always question how can parents be so ignorant of what their children are doing. But it's frightening how quickly these things can happen behind closed doors with such minimal communication, and how kids will take those secrets to the grave. Take those secrets to the grave, internet. Made an incision into a big plush toy and installed a DIY flashlight into said incision. Sure, it was way better, but afterwards I just realized I ducked a Charmander. Table's gonna turn when ya boy becomes a Charizard. Was on a family trip and tried masturbating when I was 13 or 14 using my mom's suntan lotion. Turns out it dried out my skin and I had an allergic reaction on my little guy. Ya had to show my mom cause I was scared and she knew what had happened. I cringe to this day. In the end my penis shed its skin like a snake. Disgusting and still cringy. At least you now may call it Mr. Snake for a good reason. My channel hopping at 7-9 landed me on the Spanish dubbed Playboy channel. Learned how to masturbate and found my kegels. When I was done I felt ducking awful. Anything 1 liter. Plastic and round can be grinded on or inserted. Nowadays, I realized that channel shouldn't have been free and it most likely was paid for by my dad. Edit. Jesus Christ, my notifications. Thank you everyone. I had a bad week and this cheered me up. Comma 1 liter. Comma inserted. That's a pretty massive thing to insert. I've been in this thread for an hour and a half. I need a break, Mayo. I was sleeping with a girl who was a pretty hard gusher. She sat on my face during sex once. I mathed out what was likely going to happen. But in my horniness. Kept going. Ended up getting waterboarded. My GF was on top during a 69 once and flooded my ducking sinuses. I understand. When I was 16 my girlfriend at the time invited me to Christmas Eve dinner with her family. Afterwards her mom agreed to drive me back home. My girlfriend and I were in the backseat and things started to heat up. We were making out and doing things with our hands. Like with zero subtlety. Just full bore. Blatant groping and intense foreplay. Her mom never said anything about it or told us to stop, but she must have known what was happening. The ride was 20 minutes long. I did the same thing with my first girlfriend with her stepdad driving. He walked out on her family the next day. I'm sure it wasn't related. But part of me feels like it is. Spent $400 on a dinner with two women who I believed I would have a threesome with. But we're all like 30, so by the time everyone finished eating and drinking they were wiped out, so nothing happened. This is why real ballers always have cocaine. LPT. Bang time before dinner time. Nobody likes banging on a full stomach. I visited an adult store when I was 18. When I got around the back I saw a neon sign that said arcade and a couple going through the entrance. I remember being excited thinking porn video games. Only to quickly realize there were no video games. I faintly hear the sounds of sex coming from the area. Out of curiosity, I went to the booth next to the one with the sex noises and saw her mouth from the other side of a large hole. This became my weirdest fap ever. She eventually started licking her lips and I was beside myself. What do I do? Eventually, after some self-deliberation, I stuck my dong through the hole and it was off to the races. This woman was clearly very experienced in what she was doing, but the scariest part was when it eventually stopped and I felt her backing her vagina against my dong. It looked me like 2 minutes to come. After I was done, I immediately rushed out. Went home and looked up symptoms for every STD. I was scared out of my mind for the entire week. You ducked her or in a glory hole? Ro. My man. Edit. Whoa, first gold for this. I'll take it. Thank you, kind stranger. During the AIM days, I was talking to a girl that lived in the next neighborhood over. She told me she wanted to have sex that night. Which would have been our firsts. I told her I would sneak out, ride my bike over, and get to getting it. She said she would leave her bedroom window unlocked so I could come in when I got there. I snuck out at about 2 a.m. and rode through the neighborhood with a mega boner. Got to her house just to look in her window and see she's asleep. The window is locked. Alarm is on. And after 10 minutes of tapping on the window, I accepted that it wasn't happening. I then jerked off in the bushes. I had a bike ride home full of me questioning my life choices and diving off my bike into bushes when I saw a car, thinking it was the cops. What a weird time in life. Edit. AYE. My first award. Thanks, y'all. I accepted that it wasn't happening. I have never felt such pain reading a text about a guy nutting in bushes. I feel you, man. I called a sex line and talked with a girl for like 2 hours. It costs me like $120. Problem was, once I started to begin my orgasm, she hung up on me. Never again. She wanted to edge you in hopes you'd call back and pay more. I was 14. I grabbed 2 socks. They were clean. And a rubber glove. I sandwiched the glove between the socks and then folded the part of the glove you put your hand in around the part of the sock you put your feet in, and it made it tighter. Then I squirted a whole bunch of lotion into the glove and jerked off with it. I remember when I was done, I had a smile on my face. Then I looked at it and I was like, I'm a ducking terrible person. The ingenuity of a horny teenager is a scary force. Put 2 raw eggs in my bag. I didn't have anything else. Yes, they broke. Yes, I panicked trying to get the raw eggs and pieces of shells out. No, I never did that again. Why did you do this? I can imagine the panic once they broke. This makes me laugh and also cringe. I'd love to know your thought process on this and the intention behind it. Had sex with a girl literally 2 hours after I caught another dude I know nailing her in a bathroom at a party. I was drinking and horny and she wanted to. So I thought, eh? What the hell? Why not? At least you waited 2 hours. I am from Russia and 18 years old and my English is not so good. So don't be angry to me. When I was 15. Or 16. I tried to suck my own dong when I was in tub. I couldn't do it. Then I masturbated and tasted my semen. Semen was bitter. I hope masturbate becomes the accepted past tense of masturbate instead of masturbated. I was on a trip with my parents and I hadn't fapped in several days and it was driving me crazy. Usually I would relieve myself in the bathroom when they were sleeping. But this particular bathroom only had one switch that turned on the light and a very, very loud fan. Having no alternatives, I had to fap in the dark. When I came, I missed the toilet and ended up coming all over the toilet exterior and the bathroom floor. I ended up having to get on my hands and knees and rubbing my fingers all over the toilet and nearby floor because I couldn't see where I actually came. I was so nervous that night that I missed a spot. Thankfully, I didn't. I broke my dong by accident. It was before I learned what masturbation was and I had gotten hard, so I started messing with it and bent it. Edit. Thanks for the silver, kind stranger. What, like breaking a finger? Or did you do it slowly and figured the pain was part of the experience? Pretended that a 3-foot stuffed bear of mine was my lover and taped a dildo to the poor thing so that I could ride it. In the moment I was extremely needy and sad. So the best thing for me to do, in my mind, was find something that felt as comforting as it looked and duck it, and that's exactly what I did. Admittingly, I didn't hate the experience. But I did feel really ducking silly afterwards. Lol. I was given a Tickle Me Elmo as a joke gift for Christmas when I was 12. I guess the joke being that it was a toy for toddlers and I was almost a teenager. Anyway, it vibrated, so yeah. I ate my cum off my then girlfriend's ass. Once. To put it how she did. It was one thing doing it. But what really ducked me up was you going back for more. I had a GF who was B. And was very pro B for lack of a better word. Like she thought the world would be a better place if everyone was B. ETC etc. So I decide I'm gonna do something for her that I think she'll enjoy. So we're having sex and I tell her I'm gonna come in her mouth. But instruct her not to swallow it. So I do. And then I make out with her. Then we relax. Clean up. Whatever. And she doesn't say anything. So after a while I'm like, what did you think? Did you like that? She had no idea what I was talking about. It turns out she was like in such a post-orgasm euphoria that she didn't even notice what had happened. Even when I told her about it, she still didn't remember it. So I did that for nothing. I'm pretty open-minded guy when it comes to sexual acts. My girlfriend at the time, but now ex, was also pretty happy to try anything and adventurous. We tended to stay away from having drunk sex because we both just preferred to be sober whilst having sex, as we believed it was more enjoyable. Anyway, this one time we had been out and both ended up at home super drunk and decided we would duck. It got pretty out of hand quickly, and what started as a joke of her pissing on me ended up with my laying down in the bath and her just straight up pissing all over me. A real golden shower experience. Well, obviously it was never going to be great, but it definitely doesn't help when it's the most dehydrated, scanty drunk piss known to man. Definitely was feeling pretty what have I done? After that. Edit. Spelling was no good. My girlfriend at the time and I got invited to an after party after a night of heavy drinking. She was friends with two of the four gay guys there. Some after party, I thought. Six people. They offered me some GHB, which I happily accepted. 5 milliliters, so nothing crazy. Shortly the conversation got pretty sexually charged and GF said she wanted me to duck her right there in the living room in front of everyone. Not one to turn down consenting sex, we got to doing the deed right there. Meanwhile there are four guys masturbating to the sight of me. This didn't bother me at the time because if I were gay I think it'd be a pretty awesome to witness. By the time we were finished everyone was naked and the four guys were having an orgy. The vibe had changed in the room and I was ready to leave as my own sex craze was satisfied. GF didn't want to leave, so we ended just sitting there smoking and chatting while the orgy was going on 10 ft away. Needless to say, when I woke up the next day I had a lot to think about. Once. When I was 14. My family and I were on our way back home from a road trip. I was insanely horny. We stopped at a McDonald's and instead of just spitting into my hand or getting some soap like a normal person, my horny little 14-year-old mind noticed that the metal on the handicap railing was soft to the touch. Immediately I thought, yup, that'll do, and rubbed my dong on it until I came so hard I saw stars and my body was weak. Problem was, it took like 15 minutes. When I came back down and realized how long it had been, I left in a hurry. My splodge still splattered and dripping down the wall. My family asked where I'd been. I just said I was constipated. But I think they knew. I think they knew. You believe your family's first guess was that? What kind of history did you have? Invited a guy over from my work. We had previously talked about banging and agreed to keep it a secret between us. I live in the same apartment building as our manager. This guy asked for a ride from the same third co-worker who was giving our manager a ride. And sure enough, it was public knowledge the next day. What a huge dong. I had sex with my dealer because I was desperately horny. He had a 2-inch dong and kept slipping out because his stomach stuck out much further than his dong and was getting in the way. Felt shameful and only partially satisfied afterwards. Also paranoid about catching anything because his dong was too small to fit a condom on it. Okay. Now I'm self-conscious about my dong and my stomach. My husband and I did some dirty talking to roleplay the lusty Argonian maid story from the Elder Scrolls series. He was the maid. It was hilarious at the time. But the embarrassment set in afterwards. My wife literally brings that book up anytime we talk about spicing things up in the bedroom. So there I am. Shit on my dong nom feo. There is a fat eel-like worm in Korea that looks a lot like a penis. As a young, stupid guy, I decided to see if I could stick one halfway up my ass as a joke. Its body is smooth and it has no teeth. So I figured, what's the worst that could happen? Turns out, an eel can squirm much faster than you might think. Are covered in mucus. And they're made for burrowing. I couldn't keep my grip. It went the rest of the way in and turned the tables, making me its unwitting plaything instead. It caused a very distressing squirming sensation inside that felt indescribably strange. But the strangest feeling by far was the random erections it kept causing. I was no longer horny at all by this point. Just desperately trying to get the thing out. But every now and then it'd shift around. And suddenly I would go from flaccid to hard almost instantly. Painfully hard. Like I was straining. But I wasn't. Or I didn't want to. It'd shift again and the feeling stopped. I would start going soft. Only for it to shift once more. And suddenly become rock hard again. It actually hurt. But I literally couldn't stop. It felt completely absurd. I was fighting a worm. And it was winning. I considered going to the hospital. But it was unthinkable. I couldn't imagine not only trying to explain how it happened, but doing so while dreading that any moment it might make me get an erection in the middle of it, making the doctors think I was enjoying it. Luckily, I didn't have to. It did eventually come out after a lot of effort, for which I was very relieved. What an idiot. TL, doctor, don't stick something alive up your butt. I'm sorry, what the duck? Ducking, like, and subscribe.